episode, we're going to build a revenue model for InstaDApp. InstaDApp provides a slick UI to engage with various decentralized finance applications like MakerDAO and Compound. Besides providing a way to open up loans on Maker and Compound, they also provide a way to port your loans from Maker to Compound and vice versa. This is the most interesting feature which they can potentially build a revenue model around. Let's take a look at how InstaBridge is performing. So in Covalent, we just have to go to the InstaDApp model and start exploring. What we can see here is there have been 894 InstaBridges, which is people porting their MakerDAO loans to Compound or vice versa, in the lifetime of InstaDApp. We can further break this down by month, and you can see that 200 bridges created in August of this year. Further break it down by direction, and you can see that 180 Maker to Compound and 20 Compound to Maker, and that's how it adds up to 200. Further build the ETH amount and the DAI amount and the fees that they charge. And what you can see here is that in August of this year, $2 million of Maker loans were ported over to Compound. They charge zero fees right now, but this is the feature that they can potentially build a business model around. So three ways they can charge for providing this feature. One could be a percentage of the funds transferred over. So if they were to charge 1% of this $2 million, that's quite a tidy sum, but that's not really within the ethos of decentralized finance. Realtors in the real world charge a percentage of your asset, but doesn't really make sense in this case. The other extreme is a fixed fee. So if they charged $1 per port, then they would have made $180. And obviously, as you can see, that's not really sustainable because the interest rates have been more or less stable across Maker and Compound. The third most interesting feature, which I think is also fair, is a cut of the fees that they would have saved you by using this feature. So let's take an example. If Compound were at 15% and Maker at 20%, then by moving your loans from Maker to Compound, InstaDApp would have saved you 5% per year. And so it just makes sense to take 1% of that 5% that you've saved, or whatever that proportion is. So you can download the CSV here and do your detailed analysis. One of our partners, Joel John from Outlier Ventures, has done exactly that, has built a sophisticated model and full projections for how these three different scenarios play out. I highly recommend you take a look at his blog post. I'll share a link in the show notes.